Good morning. Bo, please read the problem, and Billy, please translate.
Flippin' physics.
A 0.453 kilogram toy car moving at 1.15 meters per second is going up a semicircular hill with a radius of 0.89 meters.
Mass equals 0.453 kilograms. Tangential velocity equals 1.15 meters per second, and radius equals 0.89 meters.
When the hill makes an angle of 32 degrees with the horizontal, what is the magnitude of the force normal on the car?
Theta equals 32 degrees, and force normal equals question mark.
Mr. P, could you please clarify that angle? I'm not really sure what it means when it says, when the hill makes an angle of 32 degrees with the horizontal.
Sure, Bobby. Let me clarify that angle. As the car goes up the hill, the angle of the hill where the car is located increases. If we draw a line which intersects the center of the two wheels, you can see how the angle of the hill increases.
Sure.
And if we pause the car at the point we are talking about, you can see how the hill makes an angle of 32 degrees with the horizontal.
You know, that looks just like the diagram we used when we broke the force of gravity into components on an incline and determined the equations for the force of gravity parallel and perpendicular to the incline.
Yes, Billy, it does. And we are going to use that fact in a few moments. Thank you.
You are welcome.
Nice.
Okay, Bobby, please start the problem.
Yeah. Let's draw a free body diagram. The force of gravity is straight down, and the force normal is up and perpendicular to the hill. That's it. So let's break forces into components. The car is moving in a circle, so we need to break forces into components in the in direction and a direction which is perpendicular to the in direction, which is, in this case, tangent to the circle or in the tangential direction. The force normal is in the in direction, so we don't need to break that into components. That means we need to break the force of gravity into components in the in direction and the tangential direction. However, because theta is just like an incline angle, we have our equations for the force of gravity parallel and perpendicular, which use the angle of the incline. We don't have a numbers dependency, so let's not plug in numbers just yet. Let's just redraw our free body diagram. The force normal is still there, but now we have the force of gravity perpendicular, which is in the out direction, and the force of gravity parallel, which is in the tangential direction and down.
Billy, please finish the problem.
Now we sum the forces in the in direction. The net force in the in direction equals force normal minus force of gravity perpendicular. And the net force in the in direction equals mass times centripetal acceleration. Add force of gravity perpendicular to both sides to solve for force normal. And now we can substitute in equations. Force of gravity perpendicular equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times cosine theta. And centripetal acceleration equals tangential velocity squared divided by radius. Next, let's plug in numbers. So that's 0.453 times 9.81 times the cosine of 32 degrees plus 0.453 times 1.15 squared divided by 0.89, which equals 4.4418 or 4.4 newtons with two significant digits.
Very nice. A couple of things to point out. First, the tangential velocity of the car, 1.15 meters per second, is an instantaneous velocity at a specific point in time because the car slows down as it goes up the hill. Second, the magnitude of the force normal decreases as the car goes up the hill, both because the instantaneous tangential velocity of the car is decreasing, but also because the force of gravity perpendicular decreases as theta, the angle of the hill, increases. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.